Please stand for the salute to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Pump School. Today is Friday, September 23rd, 2016. I'm Robert Nugent.
And I'm Maddie Gunzarowski, and you're watching another groovy edition of KTV Live Flashback.
Now, I know it's only the beginning of the show, but I want to get some energy going.
Yeah.
So, I don't know how we could really do that other than dancing.
Yeah.
So, why don't everybody in the... No, actually, let's not do that because we have a great show ahead. Maybe we'll do that
That's
later.
That's true, yeah.
Today's KTV birthday is Bruce Springsteen. According to famousbirthdays.com, this rock legend struck fame in 1984 with his critically acclaimed album, Born to Run, in 1984 with his rock anthem, Born in the USA. He won his 20th career Grammy in 2009 with his song, Working on a Dream. Today, he is turning 67.
Today's KTV holiday is National Checkers Day. WeirdHolidays.com stated that checkers dates back all the way to 12th century in France, but no one is sure who invented the game. According to Wikipedia.com, in England and other English-speaking communities, the game we know as checkers is called draughts. Arthur L. Samuel was the first to program computer checkers in 1952.
Lauren recently got a few students to perform karaoke to a well-known 70s song. So I learned a song that is Sweet Home Alabama. So while we're waiting for the video to get up, maybe we should get into sports. All right, so while we're waiting for that amazing video to get up, I know you are here with the sports, and
yeah,
I'm really excited to hear
sports.
About them.
So, Texans lost to the Patriots 27-0.
So that's Thursday Night Football,
yeah.
The kickoff to week three, and there was a shutout. That's a pretty big...
Yeah, it's a pretty big game. Yeah. And then in the MLB, the Tigers beat the Twins 9-2.
That's a pretty large gap there. And I know the Tigers are a pretty good team.
Yeah.
So.
And the Red Sox beat the Orioles.
So that's a pretty good.
Yeah, that's a pretty good team.
That's pretty good. I know the Red Sox and Orioles, there's a lot of history there.
And to end it off, this was a really good game, the Mets and the Phillies. It was 9-8.
And I didn't actually watch this game last night, but I saw this morning on ESPN that Ostrubel Cabrera, because I'm a Mets fan, hit a 3-run walk-off home run in the bottom of the 11th.
That's amazing.
That is so good.
So
I think we're going to get into the video now. So I'll see you later while we get into the video.
Bye, Robert.
Bye.
Turn it up.
Sweet Home Alabama, rather, was released in 1974.
There is a girls' soccer game today at 4 in Linden.
So we already did the sports, so let's go back to Maddie with the next segment.
If you would like to join KTV, KTV Infinity, there will be a meeting next Wednesday. KTV Infinity is the school's social media and multimedia club. Mr. Sirweed stated that KTV Infinity is for students who like to share photos, research school events, and share opinions online. The meeting will be after school in room 23 until 3:15.
During the 70s, there was some pretty iconic fashion. Do you know a lot about 70s fashion? What was not a fashion trend in the 70s? Is it A, tie-dye? Is it B, Converse sneakers? Or possibly C, platform shoes? Today, the 70s are mostly known for bright colors and flowy patterns. And the answer is B, Converse sneakers. Even today, fashions from the 70s are still here. All right, so we have an amazing flyer over there.
Yeah, with Natalie.
Yeah. So let's just go check that out. Yeah, so like Natalie said, I don't play roller hockey, but that still does sound very cool. I don't think I'm going to do it, but yeah. Anybody interested, you should definitely check that out.
Yeah.
So let's just get right back into the news.
Yep.
The Billboard Hot 100 News is a chart that displays the most popular songs. The most popular song is Closer by the Chainsmokers. Next is Heathens by 21 Pilots. And third on the list is Cold Water by Major Lazer, featuring Justin Bieber and Mo. Closer has been on this list for 7 weeks.
There will be an interest meeting for all those interested in participating in this year's musical, cast and crew, directly after school in room 18 on Wednesday, September 28th. All are welcome to attend.
All right, so Jacob, you're here with the weather, and
yes,
it's looking pretty good outside.
It's looking pretty decent.
I'm hoping we have some good weather for the weekend.
It's colder right now, but...
So give me some good news, please.
All right, so today it's going to be a high of 88 and sunny, which is really good.
That's 88? Even, like, now we're in fall because summer just ended,
especially now since in the morning it's like 60 or something like that. Then Saturday it's going to be 74 and partly sunny, which isn't
It's not too good, but I mean it's still in the 70s, so it's not bad.
It can still get better though.
Yeah.
And then Sunday it's going to be 71 and sunny.
So the sun's out, but it's not really showing because it's only 71 degrees.
Make any sense. And the same thing on Monday, 71 and sunny.
So it basically just stays that from Sunday to Monday, but Sunday I will be watching football.
Me too.
I don't really know if we have to go outside.
Yeah, I feel bad for the players.
Yeah. So let's just get back into the news.
All right, see ya.
There is a mandatory NJHS meeting on Monday morning in room 9. Officers should be there at 7:30 a.m. and all other members should be there by 7:40.
Recently, Jack got a chance to interview Mr. Peets on the 6th grade art class, so let's pass it over to him with more on that.
Thanks, Robert. So I got a chance to interview, as you know, Mr. Peets about the 6th grade art. They made self-portraits. So let's go to the video on more of that.
Currently, what are the 6th graders doing in art class?
The 6th graders in my art class are learning the elements of art. And right now, they are doing color theory and value. Their project is going to be on painting a self-portrait, but they have to choose specific colors. They have to use their color theory to make an appealing image.
Why did you choose this project for your 6th grade class?
The 6th graders are doing this right now because at this age, when they step into middle school, they need to start to apply the elements of art and the principles of design into their artwork, and instead of making random choices.
The 6th grade art periods are 8 and 9. All right, so we're actually not going to get a preview because we're running low on time, but I'm sure Monday's show will be amazing.
Yeah.
So we don't even need a preview to
That's
know that.
That's true.
So for even more KTV news, subscribe to us on Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and Facebook. For Maddie Gunzarowski and the rest of the KTV news team, I'm Robert Nugent. Have a splendid day.